awesome to be here at Bitter End. For a boy from Brooklyn, it's pretty fucking cool. I like to go to, I spend a lot of time in bars. I mean, like a lot of time. I don't spend nearly as much time as I want to, but probably far more than I should. This is about, among a lot of really good candidates, this one's about my favorite bar in Chicago called the Gallagher Cabaret, which is run by a guy named Kenny Strandberg, who's like 80 years old. And music every night of the week, never cover charge, which they make work with their business plan of not paying the musicians. And this song, Left Home Early, did well for me in a lot of ways. And if you happen to be a Grammy voter, this is for your consideration. Anyway, the song's called Kenny's. Or, it's always Christmas in this bar. It's always St. Patrick's and also Halloween. Nothing here is ever thrown away. Here the heart always has its say. Kenny hangs a bread and works about every 30 days. Look around, it's the 4th of July. It's always Christmas in this bar. At the bar, once more, he's just a xenophobic jerk. The piano's always out of tune, but just the keys that work. The sound man brings the night away. The things might be to say, but you better hail for hell's most festive holiday. Boy, that ain't only the piano that's been drinking. The bar. Someone's playing the house guitar. It's always Christmas in the bar. Well, here goes Johnny. That was his last bender. He makes a cocktail behind the bar. He's got on his silver rings. He's put on a broad brim smile. He's got a brand new turquoise bow tie. For every woman he's got a pie. He'll need one more bender, and he won't return that time. Tobacco, but he says, of yours in the cops. One day, night, some guy drove a drunken car in the front wall, ready for the bar. Thank God the pizza lived, some of us might just starve. All you need to do is say yourself a prayer by yourself 2 years. Yeah, I always try to tip the cook named Scotty. If I find that Scotty would still stand. And I'm proud to say I ain't never throwed up after a year. Yeah, you know that somewhere on the earth I met you far at that stranger. The sound man is flipping real fast and Johnny's gone. Over the there's just a stranger here, but less than a half a beer. The only fear we got is here. So last calls, call. Oh, and it ain't only the piano that's been drinking. Listen, tell me, friends, or else have you seen people juggle people with their feet? Like the Picasso, George Bernard Shaw, hope over candy stuff in the bar. Isn't this a fucking great band? I mean, really. Andon Davis on the electric guitar. Rick Burkhardt, famed from play three pianos and many other great things, on the accordion. Maestro Scott Daniel on the fiddle. BIll Kavanagh on the bass. And my main man from my old band, the Dysfunctionals, Vince Edmonds on the drums. That sounds all right. This is about unrequited love, which is the best kind because it's cheaper. Song This song here, this is a song here. This song here is a. A song from the 60s called by Gordon Lightfoot. This isn't it, but it was a song that was made popular by Peter, Paul, and Mary called That's What You Get for Loving Me. It's a good idea for a song. This one's called Girls Go for Assholes, and I hope you like it. Thank you. if any of you are songwriters here, just to let you know in this audience, there's really a lot of very fucking amazing people in this room. Really amazing, accomplished people. So you should stick around and mingle. I'm not going to blow anybody cover by telling you who they're here, but... Yeah, I'm kind of unclosy. But in any case, if you are a songwriter and you're going to write a love song to a woman, if you're going to write a love song to a woman, do it before you're married because you get a lot farther with it. Well, as for me, day breaks good for wonder. So I wonder when the hell chose me as the luckiest kind of. Now I agree that no one deserves this. But then again, when was the last time you got what you deserved? I agree, this event. Did your mama teach you to keep your love from dreamers? Dreamers all turn cruel. Protect yourself, protect your heart. They say that a life is best kept foolproof, though it's a death. Don't test a genius as a fool. It's just past noon. I'm just past thinking. And when it gets this hot, you waste your time on each and every dream. And so I'm trying to keep real still. I don't worry what God is up to. See, the devil's thing, it don't seem so hot to me. Is it bad? That gypsy tell you when you slip your chin and have a look at your future so far? Did she smile? Did she cover it? Well, moon rises on Saturday, and say, all you need to know is who you are. Scott Daniel on the film. Job. So I have a really weird, it's weird even if it isn't your straight gig, but my straight gigs, I'm a doctor, and I take care of babies, sick babies, premature babies, and otherwise babies, and it's good work, because it pays for shit like this.
And it saves lives.
And it saves lives, that's right. Woo! Speaking of saving lives, this is about one of those examples. The story about this is like we were playing a pub, actually a big beer hall in Chicago, and they set up the gig. It was an afternoon thing. It's sure this is fine. And then like months went by, and then they called me up right before, and I figured they were going to cancel. But no, they said, "Oh, by the way, it's a theme night, and you need to write a song about a theme." Okay. And so what was the theme? And the theme was birth. So it's like right up my street. So this took about 15 minutes to write. And it's all fucking true.
Thank you.
but sometimes you look back on your life and you think, yeah, I fucked that up. And this is one of those moments. This is about my first girlfriend. And our first day was at the back in 77. If any of you were alive in 77. I was 17 in 77. And,
everybody here was alive in
77. That's right. Okay, fine. We often play bars where, like, nobody's ever heard of 1977. Actually, Peter has, like, forgotten all of 1977. For other reasons. What was I talking about? Oh, yeah, so this is about my first girlfriend. And, like, so I, like, then tried to reach out to her and say, hey, I wrote this song about us. To which she responded, get over it, it was 30 years ago. Are you stalking me? Which is not true, because I wasn't trying to stalk her. I was merely thinking about it. And this is called 77 and 17. Yeah. case anybody didn't know where the riff and the stole for the first song, figure that out. Because this song's called, it's like Fall Over. F. Sometimes I put the capo on in the wrong fret and then I play it in a different key than the rest of the band. But you never know it because they just follow me. It's eerie. I have CDs for sale. The beautiful Maria Kavanagh is offering them over here if you want a CD after the show. They're $15 a piece, but you can buy two for $25 because there's two titles, which have been. And again, it's better in tune. Andon fixes guitars and he's trying to teach me not to press so hard on the strings. But that, you know, I don't learn real good.
That's what this thing's for.
About the Don in Washington, but that Don and this Don probably get along real well. Here we go. This song is called Don. Something I must tell you, but I'm gonna tell you to believe anything I say. Though I swear on my children's heads that all of this is true, you should never ever trust anyone who wants to entertain you. When I was 14, I made a friend. He was 14 too, with his beard like a mobile. More than any of us about World War II. That was in our school where most kids were in shoes. Our school alumni even included a couple of the Netanyahu's. Don was what we call a contrarian. Quoted Nietzsche, he loved Hitler and said one day he'd join the Klan. The burbs of Philadelphia, there were no Kriegers that we knew. Besides, they never let him in. See, Don was Catholic too. Though we weren't yet 15, we rolled out his daddy's Rolls Royce. It was the nicest ride I've ever had in this day. Our crow was down Broad Street. We shot for clothes, cigarettes, and throwing knives. We took in a matinee. A very famous known coward play. Well, after Douglas Fairbanks Jr. met us at the stage door, and I wanted to talk to him and get an autograph. Douglas Fairbanks Jr. knew the actress Greta Garbo over the world. Don had stacks and stacks at home. Greta Garbo movie stills. He also had stacks of the porno tabloid Screw. Said his lawyer found a new Al Goldstein well. 14, but I knew a little something about Sam. Before those riots were over by, my imagination had closed my eyes. Don's real obsessions, most prized possessions, were guns. He had his own private cache of weapons. He even owned a cult color rifle just like the one that Lee Harvey Oswald used. That is, if you believe anything that the government says is true. Why did a kid like me who knew that all of this was so wrong want to pal around with a guy like Don? Might as well ask, why would Bonnie Parker, why would Nathan Leopold? Why would Eric Harris want to hang out with Dylan Klebold? One day Don's parents sent him to a military school, the way parents like kids always think they should. Yeah, I never really tried to keep in touch. I never thought I'd see him again. Kinda hope I never would. Then one day Don reappeared and he beckoned me over to a car. He sat in the front seat and talked, but not without alarms. He wore a full military dress and said he was on the run for beating up an officer. And by the way, that was not his car. I ain't made up my own mind about it to this day. But see, there'll always be kids like us who just cannot fit in. Go through the world as strangers, on the outside looking in. Something angry, something alone, some tread of twisted men. Some become songwriters, others sociopaths. But I thought it kind of me to tell all of this to you. You're wondering just how much of this is true. But what I want to know now is, did I entertain you? Well, did I entertain you? Dark and bleak.
Yep.
And you're at wit's end. And you don't know who to turn to or where your next dime's coming from. There's always plenty of money for anyone who's willing to fake his own death. Get me a great big truck, load her up with everything I own. Blow my last $5 on gas, then drive up to the high cliffs overlooking the sea. Me and everything I own. I'm gonna stop and contemplate the ocean. Reflect on our lives as our lives surely passes by. And the boss is wondering where park your lazy ass. They're gonna miss me when I'm gone. Well, me and everything I own brought along a few things that I stole from my neighbor's homes. It's okay, it's okay. They're all insured. I saw that I was the one that sold it to them before me and everything they had headed for the hills. Then the boss is wondering where I'm at, where this month's payroll went. It's a great way to spend your latter years on a material need. Found my truck at the base of the cliff where the surf runs away. The sad remains of everything I own. The police suspect the foul play. Although my corpse was never found, they figure it washed out to sea. In the insurance game, tragedies like this have a name. Double indemnity. And the boss is wondering where I'm at. Knowing that asshole is pretty stressed. Me, I'm living a little like Paul Gauguin on an island with women underdress. The only difference is I am very rich. Oh, and I'm extremely happy. And who says that you can't take it with you? Here's the dying young, and everything I own. Sat in the corner with that amplification, played my guitar to like a room full of people who were there because it was cheese night. It was awesome. This is a song called, this was written train ride out from Liverpool Station, London out to Cambridge. It's called Young. But when on the train I took, there was this young lady sitting across from me on the aisle who I didn't know had headphones on and this funny Walkman and or something. And I figured she was listening to what I was listening to at the time, which was Billy Bragg. So this is called Young English Romantic Song. I've stumbled on the truth. Usually it proves to be just medical opinion. And she left me today. It settles in my chest, it just hurts to get away. But over her from headphones across the aisle on my train. Young English romantic sings of politics and rain, and it's pouring outside. Couldn't ask for better weather. Wanna run and hide, but all I can do is remember when she lay by my side. And when fuck my cats and dogs. It doesn't rain like this in summertime. I pick up the phone and I put it to my head. Maybe I'll hear the sea. A bit one-sided conversation and ringing the waves. It's not even me to ring her up, cause I know just what she'd say. That is if she was even home. I said, I'm up again, babe. Gonna need at least one more pint tonight. I'm nearly overcome by thirst. By the strange desire to leave. More than I expected. Now my heart has turned out a bureaucrat, so invested in the system. But it's too frightened to listen, and it's still pouring outside. But I know you very much for coming. The CD's over here. Make sure you drink your 2 drinks or 4 drinks. Thanks very much. You guys want to hear another song? No time? Okay. You'll have to buy a CD then. There you go. I apologize, but we've been told. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming. Thank you very much for coming.